Well, the old app is not giving me the 3-2-1 go. All right. Hey, Coach Scott here with my assistant, Ava. And I am creating a new show. We're going to do this on Fridays. We're going to call this Fitness Friday. One, it sounds exciting because it's Friday, and we're going to talk about fitness. And I put a little post out earlier today, and I was just asking, like, what troubles you? What troubles you with fitness? You know, what's keeping you from maybe, you know, I don't know, losing weight? What's keeping you from starting a new program? What's keeping you from making this a new habit? And so the two things that I remember one of the people out there said was, it was motivation. Somebody was saying, how do I stay motivated? And I'm thinking that was Kathy out there. So Kathy, thank you for your question. And then there was one more, and I'll talk about that one later. Hey, what's up, Melissa? Okay, so motivation, and I made a little note behind me, and I don't know if this is gonna be super helpful for you to see, but when it comes to motivation, motivation's hard. Motivation's super hard because it's an emotion, you know, like when you're out with your friends and everybody's like, we're going skinny dipping, you know, and everybody's like, yeah, let's do it. And then you get to it, you're like, well, I don't know, I don't really think I want to do that. That's not really a smart thing to do. And here's the thing, when it comes to motivation, that was probably a really bad example, but you know what I'm saying, it's like all in the motions, right? You know, it's like being out and you're having dinner, you're out having some drinks with some friends, and everybody's like, hey, we're gonna go lose some weight, let's start working out, we're gonna go running tomorrow, right? So We need to acknowledge the emotion, because that's when it's super, super high. And here's the thing with motivation. It comes and it goes, okay? It comes and it goes. And so these two things, I had this whole list of things, and what I came up with was just, I just wrote two things, because my next thing I'm gonna talk about, starting your fitness routine, whatever it is, you gotta be simple. So now I'm jumping ahead. Here we go. So when it comes to motivation, first of all, you gotta commit to something. Okay, you gotta commit to something, and then you gotta have like an accountability partner. Okay, now this accountability partner can't be that person that texts you at 6 a.m. and was like, hey, are you not feeling it either? Yeah, me neither. You know, you wanna have somebody that is not going to take any of your BS, right? It's gonna be the one that's saying, hey, why weren't you there? Or, hey, you committed to something. Here, I didn't even mean to kind of go down this rabbit hole, but that's where I come in with my athletes. Like, I'm friends with my athletes. When I'm in the role as a coach, I do not let that get in between my role as a friend. And vice versa, but you know, a real friend's gonna hold somebody accountable, but the coach is definitely gonna hold you accountable. You know, so I'm not saying that you need to have a coach. Maybe I am. That's actually like my go-to at all times. Coaches need coaches, but you need somebody that's gonna hold you accountable. Okay, so going back to it, and I know it's simple. It's super simple. Okay, but you gotta commit to something, right? Like right now, write something down. Write what one thing that you want to accomplish. You know, if it's I want to lose weight, or it's like I just want to feel better. You know, like I tell all my athletes this: beach season's like 5 months down the road. Like we better start moving and getting in beach season mode, right? But yeah, like let's commit to it. Let's write what it is. And then once we write what it is, then we write like a little bit further. So here I'm going to go down a little story. Is I meet with athletes all the time, especially when we're doing our 6-week program, which today is day 42 of our 6-week program, and today is graduation day. But I'll sit with men, I'll sit with ladies, and they'll initially tell me, hey, you know, my goal is to lose weight, you know? And I know that, I mean, it's a common answer, but there's a lot of stuff behind the I want to lose weight. And so if you ever sit down with me and you let me know kind of like you want to lose weight or you want to, you know, this, you know, you fill up, you have your goals, okay? I'm going to peel that onion back till it's a bare, bare core because there's something else involved in that, okay? So going back, commit to something. Write down why. You know, why do you want to lose weight? You know, why do you want to feel better in a bathing suit when you're in front of your significant other and out with your friends or whatever? You know, just you got to have that reason because that is going to be what keeps you moving. Is not the, hey, I want to lose weight. It's the why I want to lose weight. And just to follow it up, it's the accountability. Find the accountability. So write it down, and I would say if this is something that really matters to you, like do it now. Don't click off this video and be like, man, that was kind of cool. Do it now. The next thing is, this is like on a different subject, but you know, how do I start? You know, how do I start working out? How do I start moving towards where I want to move, like when it comes to fitness, when it comes to goals, you know? You need to have a program. You need to have a program. You can't just wing it. You can't just look on your phone, you know, close your eyes, point at something, and that's your workout for the day. I mean, you can, but it's not smart, right? You want to have something that's structured. You want to have a program that is successful, that has shown results, that has shown to be successful. You know, look around. Look at your friends. Who of your friends are doing something and you're like, you know what? They are killing it. You know, who is that? And then find it, you know, go do what they're doing. You know, and this is gonna be a little plug, you know, every Saturday in Mount Shasta at Stoneway CrossFit, we have Bring a Friend Day. We're actually calling it the Community Movement Project, where we're having people in the community come in and just train with us, move with us, you know? My hope is that you stay with us. My hope is that you hang out with us throughout the whole week. But overall is I want to create awareness, you know? I want to create an opportunity, an answer to people's questions out there, all right? So here's the thing, you know, when it says like, how do you start? Simple. You start super simple. Right? Don't complicate it. Don't get crazy with your diet and then you're going to train 5-6 days a week and you're going to do all of this stuff. Like, whoa, right? We're in this for the long run. You're in this for the long run. So start simple. Start within your means. Like, if you haven't been working out for like a couple years or months or whatever, you know, fill in the blank, like, ease in, you know? Like, if you haven't been doing this for a couple years, like, come in 2-3 days a week. Do something 2-3 days a week. Minimally do something for 30 minutes. I think 30 to 60 is awesome. So keep it simple, super simple. Don't go and reinvent the wheel. Keep it simple. And then pick one thing at a time, meaning what I just said a little bit earlier about the nutrition, getting crazy about that. Like, hey, if you want to focus on your nutrition, then focus on your nutrition. And then even pull that back a little bit further. And maybe it's like getting rid of your grains, you know, or getting rid of your dairy, like both of those. You want to get those out of your diet, by the way. But maybe on a regular basis, getting rid of your grains, okay? And then start to build on something else. Then start to build on getting rid of your sugar, or maybe you're already getting rid of your sugar already. So don't get crazy. Like, if you're just kicking it off and you're starting, like, you want to be there here doing this like 12 months down the road. You don't want to be 3 months in and then you're that statistic that's quit, right? So don't be that guy. Don't be that guy. All right. So simple, and then pick one thing. And I would say this, start working out. Start getting active, okay? Start getting active. Fitness Friday. This is something that you can rely on. And down the road, I'm going to start having fitness professionals join me, and I'm going to have like a little interview with them. Okay? So keep this on your radar, Fitness Friday with Coach Scott. And sometimes I'll be in Seattle. Sometimes I'll be in Mount Shasta. Maybe I'll sometimes be some other place. But I'm going to try to pull some other professionals. Take that back. I'm not going to try. I'm going to. Okay? I'm going to be pulling some other fitness professionals that are down in Southern California that are up in Seattle. I'm going to bring in a bunch of my coaches up in Seattle because those guys are a bunch of badasses. But yeah, that's Fitness Friday. Thanks for hanging out. I see Melissa was here, and I see Cresta. Awesome. Thanks for being here. Hey, have a great Friday. Go inspire somebody. Go bless somebody. Go surprise somebody and be awesome to them. All right. Coach Scott, having a great Friday. I'll see you here on Saturday. If you want to come on Saturday, let me know, and I'll get you a free week pass. All right, Ava, close out with your that one trick you just showed me.
Which one?
The handstand walk. This is going to be pretty cool. Ready? She's been working on this. Ready? Yeah! That's good stuff. Practice makes perfect. All right, guys. See you. Have a great Friday. Bye.